Broadcast television, whether analog or digital, sends out 60 distinct images per second. The most obvious way to do this is to send out a sequence of complete frames, with each frame representing a whole scene. This is how movies have been made for more than a century, filmed and projected at a rate of 24 frames per second. Back in the 1930s, when television was being developed, transmitting 60 full frames per second was not feasible. So the engineers decided to remove every other line from each frame to reduce bandwidth. These sort of half frames are called fields. When fields are transmitted in quick succession, they form a full-resolution flicker-free moving picture on a CRT screen, thanks to an afterglow effect of the CRT coating. The process of meshing of the fields is called interlacing. Two consecutive fields, one consisting of only even lines, another consisting of only odd lines, form a complete video frame. So one could say that the image rate of broadcast analog television is 60 fields per second, or 30 interlaced frames per second. In an unrelated development, when color television was introduced in 1950s in North America, frame rate was reduced by the factor of 1000 over 1001 to become approximately 29.97 frames per second. Accordingly, field rate was reduced to 59.94 fields per second. Modern broadcast television has retained these rates. Depending on the capture device and software, digitized video can be encoded with different video and audio codecs with different bitrate, stored in different containers, but at least the frame rate and the interlaced structure of the video must be preserved. It is best to capture interlaced video in its native form, as a sequence of fields. Then you can decide whether you want to stop here and store the video as interlaced, or whether you want to upload it to a video sharing site, for which you almost always need to convert it into a frame-based video, the process that is called deinterlacing. Please subscribe to be notified of my latest videos. Goodbye.